Hello, iTech 4284 class. This is Cody Dixon here. Today I'm bringing you a podcast as my final project for this class. Today I'll be talking about what is one of my most favorite hobbies and interests that has been with me pretty much all of my life. That interest happens to be everything that is cars and racing, going fast and stuff like that. I could literally talk about cars all day and never get bored talking about it. Sport, muscle, tuner cars are more specific as what I enjoy talking about the most and what interests me the most. I know a lot about trucks and other cars as well, but anything that's high octane and fast is right up my alley, and I'll just sit there and talk about it forever. My interest in cars branched out from when I was a little kid, from a first probably memory of running around with my dad in the Bronco used to have. It was a 4x4 truck, and we'd constantly ride dirt hilly roads and stuff like that. Also, at a young age, I was never really actually able to drive anything, but I did have a little kid-size electric Bigfoot monster truck that you see those little kids riding around. But when I was riding around in that thing, I always felt like I could conquer the world. I was always driving over ant piles and hills and just stuff that it just make it so much more fun. It was just such a fun thing to do as a little kid. I also had racing video games as a little kid as well, since I really wasn't able to drive. I really was big into gaming as well, especially racing games. Around the age of 11, my dad got me into mini go-kart racing. This is one of the first times I actually really got to drive with something that was quite fast. There was a local track in town, and every Friday was a race day. Unfortunately, since I was under the age of 18, I would never have got a cash prize. I'd won, but the owner of the go-kart track, he owned a trophy shop as well, and he could always craft really nice trophies for the winner, and I was quite lucky to get a few wins on these race days. Actually, I have quite the collection of trophies. I'll probably like 13 or so. I have a picture of it, which I'll include in this. But one of the ones that I won, one of the trophies that I won was nearly 5 feet tall, which was bigger than me at that point in time. And it was just standing there, it's like, wow, I have a trophy that's taller than me. I felt like the coolest kid ever. Winning that trophy was one of the fondest memories of mine when I was a kid. Also, my parents were kind enough a couple years down the road to get me a racing four-wheeler. It was the Suzuki 400 Quad Sport, and we all kind of just shared it. And it was a bit of a learning curve for me because I'd never driven anything with a clutch before, so that was quite new. And it really scared me if it was first because it was quite a big motor for a four-wheeler, especially when a 14-year-old kid's riding around. And then to be control of it. I eventually got the hang of it from then on. After completing my homework and schoolwork each day, you could find me riding it sideways on some dirt road or trail across the street, out in the woods. I like to say all the experience as a kid with driving various kinds of motor vehicles or like the little video games, racing video games here, and there's really supplemented my driving ability today. I mean, like the video games essentially acted as a simulator as I grew up. Probably the strongest push for me having such interest in cars is the Fast and the Furious movies, especially the first one. I've never gotten bored watching that movie. I could literally watch that movie over and over again, and it's still just as enjoyable as the very first time I saw it. After seeing that movie as a young teen, I told myself from that day forward I would someday be the proud owner of a one-of-a-kind car. The movie is a big inspiration for a lot of the things I do car-wise. One of my favorite quotes from the first movie, and just like what Vin Diesel says in the movie, he says, "For that 10 seconds or less, I'm free."
I live my life a quarter mile at a time. Nothing else matters, not the mortgage, not the store, not my team and all their bullshit. For those 10 seconds or less, I'm free.
Okay, so I'm sure everyone who's seen that movie probably remembers that clip, as it's one of the most memorable things of that movie, and a lot of people really know about it. An interesting side note, I always tell myself it's a dream of mine to go to the address in the first movie, which is known as 1327. I'm leaving out the full address for obvious privacy reasons, because it is a real house and it is owned by someone, which I found out after some research. I didn't realize somebody had actually owned that house, but it would be cool to also visit that local surrounding area around that house in the first movie out in California, Los Angeles, California, where the whole movie was filmed. It'd be quite the long drive to go from Georgia to California, but I'd love to just have my car out there driving around that area where that whole movie was filmed. Back on topic, when I get to take my car to the tracker strip, during that time, all my worries and cares go away. It's just me and the track. All my attention is there and nowhere else. It's a peaceful state of mind for me. I'm sure everyone has their way of finding that peaceful state of mind. It just so happens that the adrenaline rush of going fast in a car happens to be mine. Not only do I enjoy having a fast car, it's also a passion of mine to customize it in a one-of-a-kind way, but not going overboard making what is commonly referred to as RICE in the car community. RICE actually has, it's more of an acronym. A lot of people may not know it. RICE actually stands for Race-Inspired Cosmetic Enhancement. Really overdoing your car is when somebody will call it RICE, but I like to make very subtle but noticeable changes to create what is called normally a clean look. Such things as rims, wheels, subtle paintwork alterations. Like on the current car I have, I blacked out the roof. It used to be white. There's also you can make performance enhancing performance enhancing changes in parts such as intake, exhaust, or having the ECU retuned, the computer, the ECU means the computer in the car retuned and remapped to make it a little bit faster, more horsepower. My first car that I am pretty much my project and starter sporty car was a 2001 Mitsubishi Eclipse GT. It was a bone stock vehicle, which means it had absolutely no previous alterations. I mean, looked like it was from factory. It was a clean slate for me. I started with a clean canvas. It was fully mine to make completely customized the way I liked. I actually lucked out and got a free set of rims for that car that normally went for a decent amount from the dealer I bought the car from. They had another Eclipse in the parking lot with rims on it, but the car was pretty much a dud. So I convinced them to switch out the rims, and they were able to do it for me. Now, the rims that I was able to put on the car gave it an instant, just mean look. I also lucked out in the fact that the Eclipse in general is a fairly cheap to customize car, as aftermarket parts were very common for the car, and it was an older model, so it's pretty easy to get a hold of the parts you're looking for, or aftermarket parts that you need. It was my project for the 2 years that I owned it, and I turned it into what I considered a show-ready car, and I was asked from time to time to have it in into several shows. Fortunately, I never really got the time to. I wish I could have. I put a lot of time and effort into the car. I learned a lot mechanically about the car, along with some electrical things along the way. electric work is very finicky stuff in a car, might I add. I got to do some electrical rewiring. Work on first. I put underglow on the car. It was give it a little bit more of an accent around the sides and the bottom, mainly along the bottom actually of the car. I didn't really stick it on the sides, make it look like a UFO. But also did a lot of rewiring work on like headlights and tail lights, and had put new fog lights on there. I had to rerun some new wiring into those several lights. So I learned a lot of electrical stuff with the car, and it was always a good feeling to me to learn something new about how cars work. As much as I loved that Eclipse at that point in time, I unfortunately had to let the car go all too soon due to several mechanical problems that I came across, and it literally just began to be a money drain. Such things like the transmission went out, the heater core went out during the winter, so I had no heat during the winter. And I eventually got it all replaced, but I only got it replaced just enough so I could at least get my money back out of it. But thankfully, I was able to hold on to it until I got the job that I have today to afford a better car. It was after a hard decision and a lot of think over between cars like a 370Z or a Mustang Cobra or a Subaru STI. I finally settled on the Hyundai Genesis Coupe that I have today. It struck a chord with me that this car was one of a kind to me, and it had that like one of a kind feel that I was searching for. The emblem on this specific car actually resembles that of a Bentley emblem, so I constantly get asked if I own a Bentley, which I find quite comical because I know I can't afford a Bentley, especially as a college student. Who am I kidding? This is also a fairly rare car, so not many people have seen them, so that does lead to a little bit of confusion as to what it is, and it can be a real head-turner. I'm always getting looks everywhere I go, and I always get compliments on the look of the car. That's the reason why I'm glad I got the car, that Hyundai Genesis specifically, because everybody has 370Zs and Mustangs and stuff like that. I just wanted it to be different from everybody else. Following suit to the Eclipse, I started with the clean slate. It was a bone stock car as well, and over the past year that I've owned it, I've turned it into what I consider a heck of a machine that it would really tear up the road, and it's really just got a really mean look that I like. I've actually named it Trax. It's a bit of a play on words. The car is a track model package, like there's various other models, like there's the R-Spec or GT or luxury packages, and the high end is the track model, and that's the one I got. It also happens that one of my favorite Transformers from the original series was named Trax, and it was a good play on words to name him Trax. I absolutely love my car that I have now, and I feel it's a hobby that will be with me for life to just continue loving cars and everything about them. I know if I could have my dream career, I would either be either doing rallycross or professional racing. That took a second to get out. As a kid, I always told myself that I really wanted to be a race car driver. As a kid, I also told myself that I would own a Lamborghini or a McLaren or something like that. Unfortunately, as I grew, I realized that I should set realistic goals for myself. But maybe I'll win the lottery someday. Who knows? However, I did realize that I did need realistic goals, and one of my realistic goals today is to be the owner of a Nissan GTR 34-35 Skyline. 34 happens to be the older model, but the 35 is the newest one that's come out in the past 4 or 5 years. The Skyline is also known as the Godzilla of sports cars, and it's a really serious car. It's fastest production car that's pretty much made next to the Bugatti, and it's just overall a really cool looking car. I really wouldn't call it a long shot, and I do think it's possible, but it's something I'd have to work really hard for in the future to be able to afford that car one day. The Skyline is one of the things that keeps me pushing through school, because I know I can never own a car like that without some kind of degree and some kind of job that pays really well. And it's a really good motivational thing to keep me going through school when I know it's getting tough. It's like, well, this degree is going to get me one step closer to getting in that car one day. Actually, a little bit of a funny story before I close out here. Going with the Skyline and the Fast and Furious, I have a bit of a funny story. Back when I first started my job, there was a big manager meeting held at our specific store for other store managers across the area. And my boss was giving me a little bit of praise and telling the others how efficient and fast of a worker I was with completing tasks. And he also mentioned to them what kind of car I drive, and one of the managers stepped out. And he says, "So you're Paul Walker, huh?" And that took me a second to realize what he was saying. But I found it quite hilarious. So pretty much since then, it stuck with me, and everybody calls me Paul Walker from Fast and the Furious a good chunk of the time at work, and it's pretty funny. But then like a lot of times I'll jokingly say back, you know, it's like I'll be Paul Walker one day when I get the Nissan GTR, and kind of just laugh about it. But well, that's pretty much it for this podcast. I hope I didn't bore you guys too much. I'm glad I got to share this my passion for cars with everybody, and I hope you enjoyed it. Until next time.